Now let's generalize. Let's take this specific solver. We had a specific one for the pouring problem and one for the missionaries and cannibals, and let's generalize them. And I'm going to call the generalization shortest path search. So that's a search for the shortest path that reaches a goal. And let's take our inventory, the concepts we have to deal with. We've got paths, states, actions, successors. We have a start state. We have a goal. And so now let's figure out how we're going to represent each of these concepts. Well, paths, we already had. I don't see any reason to change. So we have state, action, state. And notice we're just doing shortest path search. We're not doing best cost search. We don't need to put in the total cost in here. We can just have the action by itself. We have states, and here the states can be atomic. We don't have to know anything about the states. In other words, a state can be anything that a particular problem wants to deal with, and shortest path search doesn't have to know about that. Now, why is that the case? Because shortest path search can interface with states through these two functions, through successors and through the goal function and through the start state. So what do I mean by that? So the start state is going to be some atomic state. We don't know anything more about that. Shortest path doesn't know anything more about that. When we go to use shortest path search for a particular problem, then we have to specify what a state looks like. But shortest path search itself doesn't have to know. All it has to know is that if you give the start state to the successor function, so successor will be a function which takes a state as input and returns a dictionary of state action pairs. Now, given that initial state that we were passed in, we can generate new states and new actions. And so the actions also are atomic. Shortest path search doesn't have to know anything about their representation other than that this is where they come from the successor function. Now, what about the goal? Well, we could specify an exact state that we're looking for, but sometimes we're looking for multiple states. We could specify a set of states, but sometimes the set of states is really big. There's lots of states that satisfy the goal. So instead, let's have the goal be a function. It's a function. When you pass it a state, it returns a Boolean. True or false, is that the goal? And with that, now we're ready to specify shortest path search. So shortest path search is going to be a function. It's going to take some inputs, and it's going to return a path, and return failure as a path if it can't find a solution. And now the question is, out of this inventory, which of these things do we have to pass into shortest path search to allow us to solve a problem? Check all those that apply.